Salpingitis is the infection of the fallopian tubes, the pair of tubes that connect the ovaries to the uterus. They function as a passage for sperm cells to reach and fertilize the ovaries, and to transport the ovule, whether or not fertilized, to the uterus. Salpingitis is one of the main causes of preventable infertility. It is also known as pelvic inflammatory disease, or PID, because the fallopian tubes are rarely the only region infected. Salpingitis is usually caused by chlamydia or gonorrhea. The bacteria responsible for salpingitis can be transmitted via the exchange of bodily fluid during non-protected sexual relations. Without the treatment, the bacteria can reach the fallopian tubes within 2 days to 3 weeks. Women at risk of contracting salpingitis are those who have more than one sexual partner, those whose sexual partner has multiple sexual partners, those who do not use condoms, those who have been previously diagnosed with a sexually transmitted infection, and those who are not regularly screened for sexually transmitted infections. Women under age 25 have the highest rate of chlamydial infection. We recommend that they be tested regularly for chlamydia, even in the absence of symptoms. During sexual intercourse, salpingitis sufferers can experience intense pain, which can last until the following day. Other symptoms include weak to severe abdominal pain, fever, abnormal vaginal discharge of a yellowish or greenish color, light or significant blood loss through spotting, as well as problems urinating. In its most acute form, the symptoms are such that the woman has no choice but to see a doctor and have it treated right away. However, with some women, salpingitis may develop very discreetly without exhibiting symptoms for months or even years. This chronic form of salpingitis can cause serious and permanent damage to the reproductive system. Untreated salpingitis can increase the risk of extrauterine pregnancy and sterility. In addition to the gynecological exam, we sometimes need to perform an ultrasound or a laparoscopy in order to identify salpingitis. We treat salpingitis with antibiotics injected into the muscles or the veins, usually combined with oral antibiotics for a period of 10 to 14 days. To alleviate the pain, we often prescribe anti-inflammatory drugs in conjunction with the antibiotic treatment. To avoid transmitting salpingitis bacteria, which can also affect men, you should refrain from sexual relations during the full course of treatment or use a condom each time you have sexual relations. To avoid being reinfected and to break the chain of infection, you should inform all your sexual partners and recommend that they be screened and treated if required. This is called the epidemiological treatment of sexual contacts. Your doctor can assist you in this process. The best way to avoid salpingitis is to remain monogamous with a sexual partner who is free of the infection. Otherwise, you should always use a condom and be tested regularly for sexually transmitted infections.